Chapter 1. Sounds and Accents. Alphabet. 1. The Portuguese alphabet is the same as the English, except that it contains no W. Following are the Portuguese names of the letters, together with their approximate pronunciations. A. A. B. B. C. C. D. D. E. E. F. F. Or. F. G. G. Or. G. H. H. I. E. J. J. K. K. L. L. Or. L. M. M. Or. M. N. N. Or. N. O. O. P. P. Q. K. R. R. Or. R. S. S. Or. C. T. T. U. U. V. V. X. X. Or. X. Y. Y. Z. 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 Note: the letter W is only used in the foreign words in which it occurs. It is called W, very much as in English. Pronunciation. 2. Vowels. For the most part, the vowels are pronounced separately, so that each one forms a syllable. The only exceptions to this rule are the nasal diphthongs. The sounds of the vowels are characterized as long, short, open, closed, and nasal. Sounds of the vowels. Phonetic value. A, long, approximating the English. A, in further. Example, sofá. A, short. A, in but. Boca, festa. A, nasal. Manso. The A sounds differ in quantity rather than quality. E, open. E, in health. Café, so accented. E, close. E, in table. Selo, sometimes accented as merci. E, short or mute. A, in winter. Caráter. E, nasal. E, in paint. Pente. I, long. E, in B. Frio. I, short. E, in it. Quasi. I, nasal. E, in pin. Injusto. O, open. O, in not. Pó, so accented. O, close. O, in note. Boa. Avô, so accented. O, short or mute. O, in block. Locação. Cravo. O, nasal. O, in long. Pompa. U, long. U, in blue. Peru. U, short. U, in boot. Only shorter. Tribu. U, nasal. U, in room. Tumba. U is silent when preceded by Q and followed by E or I. Aqui. Y is pronounced E, as if it were I long. It is nasal when followed by M, as tímpano. Y is much used in Brazil in words of Tupi origin, as Ivaí, Apodi. Diphthongs. It is customary to regard as pure diphthongs such vowel combinations as AE in pai, AI in vai, AU in pau, EI in lei, EO in deu, EU in breu, OE in herói, IU in viu, OI in boi, UI in fui. It is to be noted, however, that these combinations are pronounced not as single sounds, but as if the letters were sounded separately, yet with a slight abbreviation from the full values of the separate vowels. The true diphthongs are known in Portuguese as the nasal diphthongs. These are ãi, as in mãe, ão, as in mão, oi, as in põe, ui, as in muito. Muito, however, is a unique case. 4. Nasal sounds. There are nasal sounds for most of the vowels. These are indicated either by the nasal diphthongs or by the single vowels followed by M or N, as tão or tão, bem, sim, bom, These words are pronounced as if they ended with an English ng, in which the g is not heard. Tão is pronounced nearly as if written T-O-W-N-G, with the ng sound omitted or cut short. Bang is pronounced as if written B-E-N-G, but without the G being sounded. As if written O-O-N-G, but omitting the G sound. All syllables ending in ing, 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 on, 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 and um have the nasal sound, whether at the end of a word or followed by a consonant. 5. Consonants. The consonants not mentioned here are pronounced as in English. B is silent in sujeito, subject, pronounced as if written sujeito, and in sujeitar, an old form of sujeitar. C with the cedilla, cedilha, is soft as in French. The cedilla is used to soften the sound of C before A, O, and U. Calças. C is silent when followed by T or C. Ativo. Ação. Except. Convicto. Pacto. Fricção. Convicção. CH has the sound of SH in she. Chá. Before consonants and in words of Greek origin, it has the sound of K. Cristo. G is hard before A, O, and U in all cases. Before E, I, and Y, it has the sound of the French J. Gelo. When G would ordinarily precede E or I, U is added before those vowels in order to give or preserve the hard sound. Entregar. To deliver. Has entregue. For the past participle, thus preserving the hard G sound. G, when followed by N, is silent. In the words, sinal, ensinalar. In words beginning with assign, as assinar, assinatura. H has no sound of its own in Portuguese. It is not a letter, properly speaking, but an etymological mark or sign. It has a value, however, in connection with C, L, N, and P, which C. J is pronounced as in French, like G in Mitch. LH is pronounced like Li in Million. In writing and printing, these two letters belong to the syllable whose vowel follows and must be kept together. The syllables of cordilheira are cor di lhei ra. Of filha, they are filha. M at the end of a word or syllable is nasal. Bem is pronounced as if spelled B-E-N-G, but without the final G sound. Bendito. In some words, the M is apparently silent on account of the nasal sound. Dano. N never ends a word in Portuguese, except irmã, sister, imã, magnet, hífen, colon, and certain antiquated forms like cristã, for cristã. When it precedes final S, it is nasal. NH is sounded like ni in union, that is, like the Spanish N tilde, the Italian GN, or the French GN. Banho, bath, lenha, firewood. In syllabication, these two letters, when so pronounced, always belong with the vowel that follows them. Lenha is divided lenha. There are a few words, however, which are compounded of the prefix ang or in, in which the NH is not so pronounced or written, such as anidro, inábil, inalar, inibir, inumano. P is silent before T. Pronto. escrito. Except that the P is pronounced in captar, raptar, optar, repto, and mentecapto. In isenção, also the P is silent. PH is pronounced like F. Fotografia. Q is always followed by U and always has the sound of K. QU varies somewhat. Before N and O, the U is sounded as quando. But before E and I, the U is used with the Q only for the purpose of producing or preserving the K sound, and is therefore not heard. Quer. Aqui. Exceptions. The U is sounded in consequência, frequente, equestre, antiquíssimo. It is also allowable to sound the U in questão. R has two sounds. When it begins a word or is double, it is rolled, as in French or Spanish. Rio. Erro. In other positions, it is pronounced by striking the tongue lightly against the roof of the mouth, almost as if pronouncing the letter D. Arara. Except that the single R is rolled after L, M, N, S. Honrar. Tenro. Genro. Henrique. Melro. Chilrar. S has the soft or hissing S sound and that of soft Z. It has the Z sound when it stands between vowels. Rosa. Casa. Except in cases of compound words where it has the S sound. It has the soft S sound in most other cases. TH has a sound of T. Teoria. W is used only in foreign words and should be pronounced as in the language from which those words are taken. X has several sounds, as follows. 1. Like the English KS in words ending in X, X, and UX. Fixar. And its compounds and derivatives. Flexão. And related words, such as flexibilidade. And sexo, fluxo, máximo, and lexicologia. Index and appendix are pronounced index and appendix in addition. Note. There are, however, some local differences in the pronunciation of some of these words. Flexão, properly pronounced flexão, in Bahia is pronounced flechão. 2. Like S, when followed by C, T, or P. Extenso. Exceto. 3. Like Z, when preceded by E and followed by a vowel or by H and a vowel. Exemplo. Exército. exausto. It is like double S or C cedilla in trouxe, ansiedade, sintaxe, defluxo. 5. At the beginning of words and in places other than those mentioned above, it is pronounced like the English SH. Most cases fall under this rule. Xarope, ex-ministro, baixo, lixo. Dialectical. 6. In certain parts of Portugal, one hears many pronunciations that are purely dialectical. In Minho, for example, the people generally say binho instead of vinho, wine, and sordado instead of soldado, soldier. In Trás os Montes, they say chapéu for chapéu, hat, chave for chave, key, gente for gente, folks. The caipiras, or backwoodsmen, of the state of São Paulo in Brazil have a similar pronunciation, which was probably introduced from Portugal. See the example quoted in the exercise at page 166. In Portugal, as a rule, the quantity of the short syllables is perceptibly shorter than in Brazil. Sobrado, perigo, and pessoa are so pronounced in full in the latter country, while in Portugal they are commonly pronounced sobrado, perigo, and pessoa. The D is pronounced in Brazil nearly as it is in the English language, but in Portugal it frequently has a strong resemblance to the English TH in these, so that desde in Portugal sounds very like desde, and dedo like dedo, the TH being soft like that in though. 7. Slang. Like other languages, Portuguese has its slang words or expressions. Such words and expressions are called calão, gíria, or geringonça. Some of them are not Portuguese, but simply fantastic expressions. For the most part, however, they are the ordinary words of the language used in some figurative or special sense. For example, estar na bagagem literally means to be in the baggage, but it is a slang expression used in regard to a person who is behindhand or who is a slow coach. Manda chuva. One who orders the rain is slang equivalent to the American expression political boss. Accent marks. 8. The cedilla is used with C to show that the letter has the soft C sound. The tio is used to show that the vowel over which it is placed is a nasal. It is only used over A and O. The acute accent and the circumflex are used. 1. To show the position of the tonic accent, especially in homonyms, where there is a chance of mistaking one word for another, as esta, this, and está, it is, seria, serious, and seria, would be. 2. To indicate contractions, in relação a, for a, ideia, with regard to the idea. Note, the omission of the accent sometimes entirely changes the meaning of a sentence. For example, matar a sede means to quench one's thirst, while matar a sede means to kill with thirst. In the second sentence, the a is a contraction of the preposition a, by or with, and the article a, the. 3. To indicate what are called open and close sounds of the vowels e and o. Café, mercê, paletó, avô. Tone accent. 9. Tone accent is a matter of so much importance in Portuguese that it is often quite impossible to understand the spoken language when the accents are improperly placed. Take as an illustration the word sabia. The accent may make it sabia, a learned woman. Sabia, I knew or he knew. Or sabia, the Brazilian robin. This kind of a case is not exceptional. In speaking the language, therefore, it is of the utmost importance that the accent be properly placed. The tone accent always falls on one of the last three syllables. There is an apparent exception to this rule in the enclitic monosyllables, which are joined to certain other words, as digo-lhe, I tell you, gostá-lo, to like it. In these instances, the addition of this enclitic does not change the position of the accent, even when it falls on the syllable preceding the antepenult. Example: fala-se-lhes. A. There are no short and compact rules for guidance in the placing of the tone accent, and to almost every rule formulated there are many exceptions. The greatest number of words have it on the penult, fewest have it on the antepenult. The following suggestions may be found useful. For the accents of verbs, see the models at paragraph 107, pages 72-75. B. The following words take the accent on the final syllable. 1. Those ending in the nasal diphthongs. Except benção, frangão, órfão, and órgão. Ãos, ães, ões. 2. Words ending in I, except álcali, espermacete, quase. L. Except words of Latin origin ending in ilis, as dócil, fácil, hábil, útil, and those ending in véu, amável, agradável, crível, nível. In. R. Except açúcar, cadáver, câncer, caráter, éter, júnior, mártir, néctar, sulfur, and a few foreign words like repórter and revolver. U, except tribo. Y, except júri, tilbury. Z. C. The following have the accent on the penult. 1. Erudite forms from the Greek ending in IA, as democracia, geologia, filosofia, autopsia, etc. Except the following, which take it on the antepenult: comédia, polícia, enciclopédia, geodésia, estratégia, necromância, farmácia. 2. Words ending as follows. List of words having the accent on the penult. Ending. Aco, aca. Velhaco. Aço, aça. Bagaço. Acho, acha. Despacho. Ato, ata. Contato. Ado, ada. Delgado. Ade. Idade. Ago, aga. Estrago. Age, agem. Estalagem. Aldo. Ribaldo. Alo, ala. Except. Escândalo. Sândalo. Alho, alha. Soalho. Ama. Panorama. Ame. Arame. Ampo, ampa. Estampa. Ança. Balança. Anco, anca. Alavanca. Ando, anda. Contrabando. Anho, anha. Campanha. Ano, ana. Porcelana. Anto, anta. Adianta. Ante. Abundante. Arco, arca. Comarca. Ardo, arda. Mostarda. Argo, amargo. Aro, amparo. Except, pássaro. Arro, arra. Cigarro. Aço, aça. Devasso. Asto, asta. Nefasto. Haste, contraste. Ato, ata. Combata. Ate, abacate. Avo, ava. Escravo. Acho, acha. Si, acho. Isso, essa. Aconteça. Edo, eda. Brinquedo. Ego, ega. Except, tráfego. Eiro, ferreiro. Eito, respeito. Eite, leite. Ejo, eja. Gracejo. Hélio, evangelho. Elo, ela. Cancelo, cancela. Elo, cogumelo. Emo, extremo. Eme, leme. Except, íngreme. Ensa, nascença. Endo, enda, legenda. Enho, enha, engenho. Enso, ensa, imprensa. Ense, cearense. Ento, enta, alimenta. Ente, presente. Erso, ersa, conversa. Erto, erta, concerto. Essa, impressa. Esto, modesto. Eto, eta, completo. Ete, canivete. Exa, perplexa. Esa, baronesa. Isse, velhice. Except, ápice, vértice, óbice. Icho, rabicho. Isso, issa, roliço. Ife, recife. Igo, iga. Except, código. Pródigo. Ilho, ilha, quartilho. Ilo, ila, crocodilo. Imba, cacimba. Indo, inda, tamarindo. Ingo, inga, domingo. Ino, ina, pepino. Into, inta, precinto, precinta. Inte, ouvinte. Ique, alambique. Ira, caipira. Isco, isca, marisco. Ismo, isma, fatalismo. Iso, paraíso. Isto, ista, revista. Istro, registro. Ite, limite. Except, trâmite. Ivo, iva, objetivo. Ixo, ixa, sufixo. Iso, isa, prejuízo. Oa, canoa. Except, nódoa, névoa. Osso, ossa, almoço. Ode, pagode. Ogo, oga, fogo. Oito, oita, biscoito. Olho, olha, escolho. Olo, ola, viola. Except, frívolo. Malévolo. Alto, alta, revolta. Ovo, revolvo. Oma, diploma. Ombo, omba, quilombo. Ona, azeitona. Onça, geringonça. Ondo, onda, redondo. Maribondo. Onga, oblonga, onha, vergonha. Risonha. Ono, abandono. Onto, onta, afronta. Onte, horizonte. Oque, reboque. Ora, espora. Except, víbora. Ânfora. Cânfora. Orso, orça, esforça. Orma, reforma. Orme, conforme. Orno, orna, contorno. Orro, orra, cachorro. Orto, orta, morto. Orte, consorte. Oso, caprichoso. Osso, colosso. Osto, osta, desgosta. Oto, ota, gafanhoto. Terremoto. Ote, serrote. Uco, uca, caduco. Maluco. Udo, uda, agudo. Ude, altitude. Saúde. Ugem, ferrugem. Uega, Noruega. Ulho, ulha, embrulho. Umo, uma, resumo. Ume, betume. Uno, una, gatuno. Uno, una, aluno. Undo, unda, fecunda. Unho, unha, testemunho. Unto, unta, defunta. Upo, upa, chalupa. Uki, batuque. Uru, ura, figura. Urro, urra, empurra. Uso, usa, confusa. Abuso. Usto, usta, robusta. Arbusto. Uto, uta, enxuto. Uto, fruto. Upto, corrupto. D. The following take the accent on the antepenult. 1. Masculine nouns from the Greek, such as astrônomo, geólogo, filósofo. 2. Absolute superlatives in imo, ilustríssimo. Ótimo. 3. Words ending as in the following. List of words having the accent on the antepenult. Ácio, palácio. Áculo, espetáculo. Áfico, biográfico. Aia, raia. Alo, fio, escândalo, except, badalo. Ânsia, abundância. Ândega, alfândega. Ânia, subterrânea. Ânico, vulcânico. Ântico, romântico. Ástico, ástica, elástica. Ático, ática, aquático. Eio, eia, passeio. Élico, evangélico. Ência, corpulência. Ênito, congênito. Érico, érica, genérica. Ério, éria, matéria. Except, bateria. Érrimo, misérrimo. Ético, ética, magnético. Étrico, étrica, geométrica. Fugo, centrífugo. Geno, gena, indígena. Ício, ícia, sacrifício. Ice, superfície. Ículo, ícula, agrícola. Ídio, ídia, suicídio. Ífero, montífero. Ífico, magnífico. Ígero, belígero. Ílio, exílio. Íneo, ínia, domínio. Írio, íria, delírio. Ítico, ítica, política. Ítimo, ítima, legítimo. Ívoro, carnívoro. Ódico, metódico. Ógico, lógico. Ógio, relógio. Except, elogio. Ógrafo, geógrafo. Ólico, ólica, diabólico. Óleo, espólio. Ólogo, geólogo. Ônico, ônica, carbônico. Ônio, ônia, demônio. Ônimo, ônima, anônimo. Ore, árvore. Mármore. Órico, órica, categórico. Óreo, ória, história. Except, categoria. Ótico, ótica, narcótico. Úncio, úncia, pronúncio. Úndio, úndia, gerúndio. Únio, importúnio. Uo, melífluo. Except, amuo. Úria, penúria. Úsculo, maiúsculo. E. There is a natural tendency in Portuguese to avoid placing the accent as far back as the antepenult, so much so that words thus accented are called esdrúxulos, a word of Italian origin sdrúxulo, slippery, which is used figuratively in Portuguese to mean odd, strange, extravagant. The esdrúxulos are few in number and are nearly all erudite forms. Quantity. 10. The tonic or accented vowels are always long. The atonic or unaccented ones are generally short. Útil. Agradável. Syllabication. 11. In syllabication, A. Diphthongs cannot be separated. B. Monosyllables cannot be divided. C. The consonant combinations LH, NH, RH, and PH cannot be separated from each other or from the following vowels with which they form syllables. Manhã. Batalha. Filosofia. D. A consonant between vowels belongs with the second one. Nariz. Bárbaro. E. G and Q followed by U remain with the vowel that follows. Guindaste. Qualquer. F. Double consonants are separated. Bel. Belo. Aflito. G. Mute letters. C in CH. T in TH. G in GN. T in CT. T in PT. Go with the following vowel. Arquitetura. Pan. Teísmo. Sinal. Fruto. Cativo. Exento. H. In nasal syllables, M and N generally belong with the preceding vowel. Bem. Dito. Manso. Dançar. I. But when the M is followed by N, both of these letters belong with the following vowel. Sono. Dano. J. Compound words are divided according to their elements. Substantivo. Capital letters. 12. The rules for capitals are the same in general as in English, except that adjectives derived from proper names and eu, I, are not written with capitals, save for some other reasons, such as at the beginning of a sentence. Francês. French. Inglês. English. This rule is not invariable, however, and one sees the proper adjective sometimes with the capital and sometimes without. The use of the capital in such cases is regarded by some authors as more strictly the Portuguese custom. In addressing persons as senhor, senhora, vossa senhoria, vossa santidade, etc., it is the custom to begin these words with capitals, but capitals are not used when a person is referred to without the name, as O senhor engenheiro tomou conta da estrada. Orthography. 13. Portuguese orthography is remarkably phonetic, and after a little practice, one can usually spell correctly words heard for the first time. The etymology of the words, however, is not lost sight of, though some writers adhere more closely to the etymology, while others tend towards phonetic simplification. The only exceptions to the phonetic writing of vowel sounds are 1. The unaccented O is generally pronounced like U, short, as bonito. 2. Unaccented E is often pronounced like I, short, as doce. A. The following will serve as examples of words spelled in different ways. For present purposes, either spelling may be regarded as correct. Aprender. To learn. Aproximar. To approach. Caridade. Charity. Comigo. With me. Dito. Said. Idade. Age. Igreja. Church. Escola. School. Escrito. Written. Lugar. Place. There are also many antiquated forms found in old books, such as é, he for é, is. Uma, with an h, for uma, a or one. São, for são, are. B. It is to be expected that the spelling of the present day should differ considerably from that of the 16th century. But, aside from these differences, one finds certain variations, called syncretic forms, that often puzzle the beginner. These come chiefly from the equivalence of the diphthongs o and oi. The following is a list of the most common syncretic forms. Either form is allowable. Açoute. Açoite. Whiplash. Coisa. Coisa. Thing. Couro. Coiro. Leather. Doudo. Doido. Crazy. Dous. Dois. Two. Lousa. Loisa. Paving slate. Multa. Moita. Coppice. Noite. Noite. Night. Ouro. Oiro. Gold. Tesouro. Tesouro. Treasure. Vindouro. Vindoiro. Future. C. On the whole, the tendency is toward the phonetic spelling, a tendency that has lately received much fresh impulse. These variations, however, are not to be regarded as license to spell words in any way.